Welcome to Paper News 24/7, brought to you by the Paper of Montgomery County Online in living color from the paper's control room. I'm Stu Clampett with your top headlines for the weekend of October 6th, 7th, and 8th, 2007. I-STEP tests moving to spring. Indiana Governor Mitch Daniels announced on Friday that beginning in the 2008-2009 school year, the I-STEP test will be administered in the spring. Students will take the current I-STEP test for the last time in September of 2008. Comments and some very different perspectives on this decision from North Montgomery Superintendent Dr. Robert Brower, Crawfordsville Superintendent Dr. Kathy Steele, and South Montgomery Superintendent Dr. Brett Lewis are all available in today's edition of the paper. Dossett to leave October 15th. Montgomery County Auditor Jeff Dossett is leaving office sooner than he anticipated. Dossett said that he was hoping to be able to stay in office until December 31st, but his last day will in fact be October 15th. Dossett is leaving the auditor's office to become the manager of the Financial Services Division for the Maximus Corporation. Montgomery County Republican Party Chairman Scott Molin said that a caucus to replace Dossett will take place within the next 2 weeks. Swearingen elected. The game of musical chairs in Crawfordsville's city government is over. A caucus of the Ward 2 precinct committeemen unanimously elected former City Councilman Don Swearingen to the vacant Ward 2 City Council seat. Swearingen was not in attendance to see the result of the vote, and attempts to contact him were unsuccessful. Swearingen was the only person on the ballot of Friday's afternoon caucus. In our continuing Remember When feature, Lane was vital to our history. Most people visit the Lane place because they like old houses. Few, if any, visitors come because they are interested in the man, Henry Lane himself. An interesting discussion of Lane's role in shaping our history is available both in today's paper and on our homepage. Muffy opens doors for nonprofits. Nonprofit agencies serving Montgomery County are invited to submit requests for funding in the 2008 year from the Montgomery United Fund for You. To be eligible for support, requesting agencies must be certified 501c3 not-for-profits. They must provide a direct human services-related program or service. They must serve residents of Montgomery County and have been in operation for at least 1 year. Application packets will be available for pickup beginning on Wednesday, and that will be at the Montgomery United Fund office on the first floor of the National City Bank building in downtown Crawfordsville. Women's History Tour Sunday. Local women's history will come to life Sunday in a walking tour of Crawfordsville. Registration will begin at the General Lew Wallace Study and Museum at 1 p.m., where the participants will receive a map of the route containing short descriptions of each tour stop. The tour is expected to last from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Information on signing up for this tour and more details are available both in today's edition of the paper and on our homepage. Candidates speak to Academy. The 17 students currently in the Montgomery County Leadership Academy had an opportunity Friday to hear from two of the three Crawfordsville mayoral candidates. Republican Steve Fries and Independent Jacob Hurt addressed the class for 10 minutes each before fielding questions from the students. Also available in the paper today, Accounting Advice with Ed Hensley and Jennifer Shook's Ahead Coalition article. This time she focuses on Red Ribbon Week, which is set to begin on October 22nd. In local sports action, you can read about Crawfordsville High School's victory over North Montgomery's Chargers in county football, and Southmont unfortunately losing their homecoming game to Western Boone. For more information on these and other stories, visit our homepage and pick up a print copy of the Paper of Montgomery County. For Paper News 24/7, I'm Stu Clampett.